morning of 9/11, I was in Manhattan. I didn't know what to do, and I spoke to a number of friends, and in December of 2001, I quit my job, and I moved to Israel to volunteer with organizations that were working with victims of terrorism. After a year and a half of living there, I was on bus number 14 in Jerusalem when an 18-year-old Palestinian boy boarded my bus strapped with explosives. He injured over 100 of us, and he murdered 16 innocent people, including everyone that was seated and standing around me. When the attack first happened, I didn't even know it was a terrorist attack. I thought that maybe we got into a bus accident or that somebody hit me in the face with something. But the last thing that I thought was that someone boarded that bus strapped with explosives to hurt and murder innocent people. I had shrapnel that went through my shoulder, breaking my clavicle bone. Both my eardrums were blown from the impact of the blast. My face was burned and bruised. I don't have any hatred towards that 18-year-old boy that carried out my attack, because it wasn't him. He was brainwashed to think that what he was doing was going to accomplish something. 4 years ago, I opened my nonprofit, Strength to Strength, where we bring victims of terrorism together globally to help people heal and move forward with their lives. I had no control over what happened to me that day. I only have control over how I live my life going forward. And I want to make sure that I show the opposite of what that day was all about by showing love and kindness to others.